I won the 2013 Australian Apprentice of the Year.
Definitely remember the night, it was pretty unforgettable. We were over in Perth and the awards night, apprentices are last, so I had to wait right till the end to figure out how I'd gone, and it was just a real thrill to be up on the stage and hear my name called out amongst so many other great apprentices as well. Professionally, that gave me a huge confidence boost and allowed me to have the confidence to take on my own business. Growing up on a farm gives you a lot of opportunities to learn how things work and have a go at things out in the shed. And Dad taught me to weld when I was 10 years old. Up until that point, and even up until year 10 at school, I sort of assumed I'd go on and do an engineering degree because it sort of followed with what I was interested in. But once I had a go at a school-based apprenticeship, even on the first day, it sort of sparked something inside me that this could be a career. And it pretty much went on from there. So I did a school-based apprenticeship, completed that. And then I went back and did year 12 because it was important to me. I thought I've only got a year to go, I'll finish year 12 and get that out the way. As soon as I finished year 12, started looking for an apprenticeship straight away. Found one and basically it all went from there. So while I was looking for an apprenticeship, having the school-based already done was a big benefit because I had some hands-on skills and that my employer could see that right from the start. Towards the end of my apprenticeship, I was having discussions with my employer. He was looking to retire and wanted someone to take on the business who had a passion for it. It was his life's work, and he wanted someone to take it on who would continue it and grow it. And also towards the end of my apprenticeship, while considering taking on the business, my employer worked with me pretty closely with customer relations, how to do quotes, how to size up jobs, and how to deal with having people work for you and how to work with people rather than just being the boss, sort of how to lead them properly. So it gave me a good insight into how business works, and really without having done that during my apprenticeship, I probably wouldn't have had the confidence or the skills to be able to take on a business and make it work. As an Australian Apprenticeships Ambassador, if someone came to me and asked me whether an Australian apprenticeship was a good idea, I would tell them that it absolutely is. It opens the doors to so much more than what you first see when you think about an apprenticeship, and when you look at apprenticeship, it can take you anywhere in the world. And if you've got a hobby, it can do exactly what it did for me and turn it into a career.